In this video, we're going to examine the difference between local grades and remote grades in the color page. It's a really cool tool that will save you time when grading sequences that reuse the same source media. Let's start with a couple definitions. A local grade. Local grades are connected to a specific instance of a clip. Let's say I use the same clip several times in my edit, and if these clips are configured to use a local grade, each instance of that clip will have its own unique grade. A remote grade. Remote grades are connected to the source media. If I use the same clip several times in my edit, when the remote grade is selected, these clips will share the same color grade. Options to switch between local and remote grades can be found by right-clicking on a clip's thumbnail in the color page. Let's check it out. At the top of the menu, this checkbox next to version 1 indicates that I currently have a local grade loaded on this clip. It's possible to create different versions of a color grade. More on that in another video. I can load a remote grade by choosing which version of the remote grade I want to load. In this instance, there's only one, so I'll hit load. You can see that the grade has visibly changed. And when I right-click on the clip, the tick indicates that version 1 of my remote grade is now loaded. Under the version submenus, you'll find useful options that allow you to copy a grade from remote to local, or create a new remote grade that copies your local grade. These might come in handy. For example, if you've started building a local color grade, but subsequently realized that it would be better to build this as a remote grade, so it can be shared with other clips. You'll also notice that there are 4 additional options that deal with remote and local grades further down the menu. They function similarly to the tools we've already discussed, but with one key difference. These will affect every clip in your timeline simultaneously. For example, use local grades will switch every clip in the timeline to use local grades. Do you remember we switched the first clip to use a remote grade? As you can see, it's now back to using a local grade. It hasn't done any copying, it's just switched it back over. Here's another example. The copy local grades to remote function is great if you've started building your grades as local, but have subsequently realized you want clips from the same source media to share grades. So in summary, you can copy grades between remote and local, and you can switch between remote and local grades. You can do that one clip at a time, or you can do every clip in one go. If you're still unsure, this demonstration should help. Let me give you a practical example of how this might work. Upon initial inspection, this edit requires 8 color grades. However, upon closer inspection, I can see that many of the clips share the same source media. Double-clicking on the information under the thumbnail reveals the source media name. Let's switch my entire edit from using local grades to now using remote grades. I can confirm that it's enabled remote grades by right-clicking. You can see that there's now a tick by remote grade version 1. Now that remote grades are enabled, the clip thumbnail view has a handy icon that shows me which clips will now share the same remote grade. There's a pink remote grade icon by all 3 interview clips. The second clip now shares a grade with the 6th clip, and the 3rd clip shares a grade with the 4th and the 5th. My color grade has now been reduced from 8 grades to just 3. How fantastic is that? Let me show you how that works. Any color grade that I now make on this clip, here clip number 3, will affect any other clip that uses the same source media, as long, remember, as I have remote grade loaded. Let's produce a really quick color grade that's very obvious by using the monochrome checkbox in the RGB mixer. This will make my image black and white, and I'll decrease the gamma back in my primaries. When I switch to the next clip, you can see that it's sharing the same color grade. Any adjustments I make on this clip, like reducing contrast, will continue to affect every other clip that uses the same source media. If I decide that I don't want this 3rd clip to share the same color grade, I can select that thumbnail, right-click, and load a local version for just this clip alone. Or if I decide I'd like to use my remote grade as a starting point, but then modify it, I can hit the Copy to Local button. You can see it's copied the grade and automatically selected my local grade in just one click. I'll add a sepia tint with the gamma wheel. Now this clip is using a local grade. The pink remote grade icon no longer shows up under the thumbnail. And when I switch to the previous clip, you can see it hasn't been affected. One final thing to demonstrate. Will remote grades work across different timelines? Yes, they do. Here's a timeline that references some of the same clips. By default, a timeline does not show remote grades. When I switch this timeline to use remote grades, you can see that the relevant clips has instantly picked up the black and white remote grade that I applied in the previous timeline. Remote grades are one of many tools in DaVinci Resolve that you can use to manage complex timelines. It complements other tools, like groups. We'll cover that in a future lesson. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, consider sharing it with someone you know, and subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos. Now, before we go, we've got some big news. We're working on our first complete DaVinci Resolve course. It will teach you everything you need to know to edit, color, and mix audio in DaVinci Resolve. Like the content on our channel, it's designed to be comprehensive, yet efficient. We think it will be particularly helpful to editors with experience in other NLEs like Premiere, who are looking to expand their skill set. But if you're a beginner, we think you'll love the course too. We just won't be spending lots of time on concepts that editors are already familiar with. We're gonna get straight in to the good stuff. There'll be more news on all of this soon. Thanks so much for watching.